Hi guys, my name is Siddharth. Welcome back to Siddharth World, your own channel. It so happens that this is going to be an updated version of the previously posted blog on how to speak English. There are many a times, many of you questions or many of you Google out on how to speak English, and then you get some fancy 10 steps, 15 steps, somebody says 5 steps, and somebody says you have to, you know, join an online course, you will have to take classes, you will have to read a lot of materials. But nobody tells that how a layman who is not fully understanding or who is confused, just by joining the class, how much is the going to be the success rate, how much you are going to attain, how much you are going to get. Now exactly the same thing I am going to answer in this. In my last blog I said you have to follow 3 steps in order to start speaking good English. Extending that, I am going to give you 3 different and more simpler steps. After doing these 3 steps, you can go back to that old 3 steps, or you can simultaneously do, and then you will get the benefit. The point is, why I am telling slow is because I can go at a very fast pace without any pause and anything, but I want you to understand each and every word. That's more important, rather than going and, you know, speaking something else and that does not work out. So understand it and let's see how it works out. All right, let me tell you. In the last blog, we had 3 steps. 1, you read new English newspapers so that you will have more words to speak, more words to get, and you will have a better understanding. 2nd, we discussed was about watching the content with English subtitle, any content. 3rd was to use that to speak. Now what happens is, somebody who is starting from the scratch, from the beginning, is very difficult. But it's not very difficult. Yes, it's difficult, but it's not very difficult. Why? Because all of us who have gone to school have studied English from our kindergarten until our and wherever we have stopped our education, we have learned, and even now we are watching. But the question is, learning never stops. Learning always goes on. So in order for us to learn, we need to realize that we have the potential, we have the power. Now coming back to how I should learn or what I should learn. Well, you have to start reading books. Books, just read. Don't understand the meaning, does not matter. Just read. Whether it is English magazine, English books or anything, just read. That is one thing. Second thing, try to find out people who speak English and talk to them. Talk to them, understand them, what they are speaking, how they are speaking. Talk to them. They will guide you, because if you commit any mistake, they will correct you, and it will be a good way of practicing. Third, never afraid of speaking. The moment you think, if I speak, if I do wrong, somebody will laugh at me, blah blah blah, don't think of that. If you think of that, then that will create a lot of trouble for you. So these are the 3 things: read books, talk to people, and start speaking. In the next part of this, I will tell you the remaining ending of it.